Beach House Dream, Shein, and Asset Light Companies. This is Ken Boyd with the Accounting Accidentally Substack page. So we just booked our flight for this summer's trip to our favorite beach location. And vacations for us involve walking on the beach, reading and drinking, and not necessarily in that order. And a pro tip, if you're having cocktails on the beach, pour them into a Yeti cup. They'll stay cold and you won't lose your drink if it tips over in the sand, something that we've perfected over the years. So every year I book this trip, I think to myself, wouldn't it be great just to buy a place? So let's do the math. The condo cost where we go averages about $700,000. Insurance, again, you're on a beach area, there's wind and storm damage possible. $1,000 to $5,000 annually, call it $3,000. Maintenance, the site that I found said, let's estimate maintenance at 1% of the purchase price every year, which would be $7,000. So $10,000 a year for insurance and maintenance cost. Now let's think about opportunity costs. What rate of return or benefit do I miss out on? Say I take $700,000, I don't buy the condo, but I invest in the stock market. How much could I earn? Well, according to Investopedia, the average annual return since its inception in 1928 through 12/31/23 is 9.9%. So let's call it 9% to be conservative. So over time, I might earn $6,000 to $7,000 annually on that investment. So I guess I should keep renting. What this article talks about is we define asset-light companies. We explain why Shein uses the asset-light business model. Talk about minimum viable product, which relates to Shein's strategy, and we illustrate how this type of business increases return on asset. So what is this asset-light company idea? Some businesses are rethinking big investments and becoming asset-light companies. So what we mean is asset-light marketplaces manage to make money from things they don't own or even control. And there are two common examples that we all know about. Uber doesn't purchase the cars before making them available for rideshare. Airbnb doesn't purchase the houses before making them available for rental. The retailer Shein has success using this strategy. So Shein's a fast-growing online retailer that's taking advantage of several trends noted by Contrary Research, which is a great source I'd recommend. Great content. A move toward fast fashion. This is the rapid manufacture of highly affordable, trend-driven clothing. These companies continually release low-cost clothing, and they don't rely on seasons of the year to create what they create for their clients. Growing acceptance of e-commerce. Who doesn't buy stuff online? I think Amazon has a truck that constantly drives around my block, throwing stuff on my front porch as I need it. It's literally that fast. E-commerce totaled over $1 trillion in 2023. And finally, buying through social media. More purchases are made through TikTok, Instagram, and other platforms. People are spending more time online. It's easy to purchase when you're using social media. So Shein's approach to retailing applies the minimum viable product concept. So what does that mean? Well, according to Gartner, minimum viable product is the release of a new product or a major new feature that is used to validate customer needs and demands prior to developing a more fully featured product. So to reduce development time and effort, that's what's important here. MVP includes only the minimum capabilities required to be a viable customer solution. So in a way, Shein is the ultimate experimenter in fashion because the company analyzes customer behavior in real time based on how they respond to marketing. And then it experiments by putting out thousands of clothing items each day and seeing how customers respond. So there are a bunch of little experiments. It takes a huge network of manufacturers, which is the key for this being successful, and each may only produce 50 to 100 units of a particular item. It's not a big order for that manufacturer. If the item sells, they make more. If not, they haven't spent a great deal of time and money on one item. So Shein's creating thousands of minimum viable products in a given year. It's a small test to see what works. Here are Shein's risks, the risk side of an asset-light business. Capacity. What if Shein can't find enough manufacturers to meet its requirements? Price. What if manufacturers charge more than what Shein is willing to pay? Finally, quality. What if the items produced don't meet Shein's quality standards and you've got to send stuff back? You've got to get it delays your production and your retail process. So what's the financial impact? Well, it's a higher return on assets or ROA. Shein can operate with less capital because it's not investing large amounts to build and maintain manufacturing facilities. As a result, it can generate a higher return on assets compared to other businesses that operate with more assets in the balance sheet. So here's an example. Let's assume a company generates net income of $10 million a year and has $12 million in total assets. The ROA would be $10 million net income divided by $12 million total assets, or 0.83. But then let's decide the company shifts to an asset-light business model. It contracts with third parties for production, and it sells off $4 million in assets. If the company can produce the same $10 million in net income on $8 million in total assets, the return on asset increases to 1.25 from 0.83. So what's the lesson here? If you can solve the challenges of capacity, price, and quality, you may be able to operate with a much smaller investment in assets and increase the return on your assets, so you're getting more dollars out of what you spend in your business. That's as far as we'll get right now. Remember that you can go to Accounting Accidentally on Substack and find more great articles. Thanks.